Yo, what's up everybody? Zan's Epic Kid here to play this new Heda game. Even if it's just a fantasy, I'll be waiting. By Tsukiko Ayanosuke and McPie Jeff. This was created for the Milk Silk game jam that started in October 2018 or November. Yeah. So this is supposedly an angel pair game, aka the England / Italy pairing, which I think is pretty cute, you know? Like, Jurita's, you know, always is gonna be my one true old TP, but this pair is actually pretty cute too, so. Yeah, and I'm always open-minded about when it comes to shipping, so yeah. Can't wait to see what happens here. Because, like, I saw all the previews about it, and I just thought it was super cool. So, supposedly, these two, they're gonna go into a fantasy adventure and stuff. Without further ado, let's get in. Vargas Home Cafe. Thank you for coming! Oh, it's a Borga. Big Brother Lovi! I'm glad that they remember Saborga. He's often the most forgotten of the Italy bros. It's closing time. Finally, I'm tired. Gio, should we get rid of the mac and cheese waffle from the menu? You use Gio as his name? Because I like that name too. Well, Romeo isn't bad either. Like, Romeo's cool. But Gio... like, dang. Huh? Why? It sounds stupid. But you were the one who put it there. That was Alfred's idea. Oh, is he dating Alfred in this? Yeah. You can't just ignore your boyfriend's idea, right? But he's my partner in crime. It's two different things. Oh, so that's what they're calling it now. But didn't you say he was your slave last? What kind of relationship is this? Just casually make each other your slaves? Can we please stop talking about that hamburger bastard? Aw, you still love him. Oh, shut up, Gio. I'm going to my room. Are you working on your novel again? Yeah, it's almost done. I'm still stuck with the ending. I hope I can finish it by the end of the month. Oh, he's a writer. Good luck on that, Big Brother Lovi. I'll call you when dinner is ready. Okay.
Aw.
And now I am Romano!
Oh my god, I love this menu screen!
Oh my god, it's so cute! There's baby English like a dragon! This is the most adorable! I hope there were proper credits put towards the art. But dang, I love this menu screen. I want to stare at it all day. Okay, I'm done staring. Okay, so there's this Lovian and Vargas. He's got no skills, but I have a big heart. Kind of. And... what's his stats? What does stats look like? Oh, C button is the stats. The oldest of the Vargas siblings, very easy to be annoyed, but still a big, great big brother. Oh, that's sweet. Yep, that's Lovino for you. Alright, what is this damn piano? My piano. One of us usually plays it during weekend shift. The customers are also allowed to play it. There's like this one with this curl that always comes to hug the piano though. I had to tell him that they needed to take turns even though his music was very good. Hello, Gio. Dinner will be ready soon. Be patient, okay? Just some supplies for the cafe. Oh, so they have a cafe. That's sweet. Sorry, big brother, but I'm a little busy here. Alright, whatever. I'll just sit here. Or not. I guess I'm just gonna go to the bedroom. Oh, wait, that's the toilet. I can go to the toilet. I can't buy shit from it. Not like those other games that we have. The This is Feliciano's room. I shouldn't go in without permission. Aw, why is he so sad? Alright, Lovino, go in here then.
Yep, my room is super bright. But super stylish. Like me. Let's see here. Maybe I should pay to read it from the beginning.
Ever wonder why everything looks so different than back then? When we were a kid, everything seemed so bright and colorful. When we were kids. As we grew up, everything became duller, grayer, and less colorful. But I know these two children who can still see those colors, even when bad things happen to them. Let me tell you a story of the beauty of imaginations and friendship.
Sounds like a cool friendship, if you ask me. Oh, we get to save! Frick yeah, best prologue ever. Oh cool, they have a blue-haired teacher.
The Declaration of Independence was a letter sent to the King of England from the leaders of America's 13 colonies.
Yep. And Nicolas Cage stole it. In search for the lost treasure. Wait.
The letter told the king that the colonies were now independent, meaning they no longer belonged to England. The letter was written by a man named Thomas Jefferson and signed by the members of Congress of July 4, 1776. And in the back of it, they also wrote a secret message that Nicolas Cage would soon find-
teacher, I don't think this is accurate history.
Oh, what do you know about history? You're just a kid.
Sorry. I couldn't resist.
That is why we celebrate America's birthday, Independence Day, on July 4th.
Because I'm the hero, dudes! Woo!
Now, there are 46 people who signed the Declaration of Independence. Can you guys tell the 5 most famous ones? Let's start from Samuel.
John Adams!
Correct! Now, Sunny. Benjamin Franklin. Very nice. Do you know another one, Katsu?
You name your kid after... after food... wait. Well, then again, it's also a proper name. I don't know. Samuel Adams. Oh, that's Curl.
Good. And what about you, Llama?
John Hancock, the President of Congress.
Excellent. And who is the last one, Victor?
Thomas Jefferson.
Oh, Victor! He's here too!
Correct! Congratulations, everybody.
Yay! We're smart!
Now let me ask. Feliciano!
Eh? Yes?
We all know that all these people work hard for the independence. In turn, what would you do for your country, Feliciano?
Make pasta? Hurry up, Philly!
Well...
yeah, we don't have all day. Oh, poor Philly.
You can't really accept much from Hitaria.
Aw, that's mean, girl. That's so true. Are they the bullies in this game?
I guess I'll...
well, Feliciano?
I wasn't paying attention. I was just daydreaming about the Leaning Tower Pizza. Don't blame me. I guess I could wait. Just in case. Just in case the others need some backup, I guess.
What a loser.
Do nothing is your specialty, isn't it, Hitalia?
Shut up. Leave him alone.
You know, everyone, it's not bad to give others your support. But next time, try to put yourselves in the mind of these great people. Okay?
Sorry.
Oh yeah, I hate that feeling. Of like being asked a question and then everyone laughs at you for your answer. Like I've had that feeling before. Memories, elementary school. A time that I'd better love to forget. Italy is no great people. Wow. He'll just disappear before anything important happened. I said shut up before I attack you with a butter knife. I'm gonna butter you up so that you can become an evil muffin and I'll eat your evilness.
Teacher, Bovino said something rude again. It's so much ruder than what I said.
It just started it.
Now, Victor Lovino. Try to be nice.
Ugh. Unbelievable.
Yeah, it's okay, Fratello.
You shut up too, it's not okay.
Sorry.
You need to learn to stand up for yourself. Don't be. It's not your fault.
Alright, let's continue. Yeah, Hitalia basically means useless or hopeless Italy, which is
kind of mean, but
I guess it was meant in an affectionate sort of joking way, because, you know, it's about one of the nations of the world and, like, all the nations are kind of Hitare at some point.
Beh. I sort of messed that up.
Don't worry. I know that feel, Philly.
But there's no way I can fit just like those amazing people.
Yeah, you can.
I can't be a hero. I'm just Italia. The useless Italian.
Aww. Alright, class. That's all for today. You can pack your bags and go home now.
Come on, Philly.
You can go home first, Fratello. I'm going to clean my table.
They messed it up again?
Yeah.
Aww.
Need any help?
No.
It's okay. All you have to do is draw annoying pictures of all your classmates and put it in your desks. That's what I did, Natch. I only did it to one classmate.
That'd be fine.
Just go home straight away after you're done.
Okay.
Aww. At least I'll be some nice big brother.
Oh, I see. His desk is dirty.
Let's clean up then. Maybe I can borrow some cleaning supplies at the cafeteria again.
I want to protect this boy.
Protect the boy!
I can't save!
Japanese TV show.
Card games on motorcycles!
I remember! Oh my god, is this Yu-Gi-Oh average? That is the best. Best reference.
Student lockers.
This is my locker. Wait a minute. Where's my diary? It's gone. I have to find it.
Oh no, they stole your diary.
Protect the boy.
Protect the boy.
I guess I was kind of like that in elementary school. Well, granted, not everyone didn't call me useless, but they called me weird. So I often just like going to the library. To pass the time in recess. What's this? Library. Can I go in the library?
Don't be noisy in the library, okay?
Okay.
Encyclopedias. Storybooks. Storybooks.
Maybe that's where I got my imagination from, going to the library. And also playing in my backyard. I'm sorry if my childhood sounds depressing, but like... I'm just saying that I can kind of connect with, like, I found friends, you know, in the end, but like, I'm just saying that I can kind of connect with Italy here, so, yeah. Kindergarten, first grade, second grade classrooms, cafeteria. Okay, Goggle. Cafeteria. Da-da-da.
Hello.
Hello. Oh, nice old lady. Hello. What can I do for you, dear?
Ciao. Can I borrow some cleaning supplies?
Of course you can, dear. Oh, this boy. He actually cares about keeping things clean. Here it is.
Tatsy.
Aw.
Protect the boy.
Protect the boy.
I'm sorry if this has become my anthem, but like, not anthem, my motto. But yeah.
Let's see here. There, I'm better. I can go home now.
Yay! Time to go home. And play with your big brother, Lovi.
I have to find my diary first. I hope it's still... Aww. Katsu! Victor!
Oh, no. These jerks. I'm in a classroom, okay? I'm in school, okay? I can't swear.
Oh, Feliciano. Is there something wrong? Have you seen my book? Oh, what book? You can talk to us, Feliciano. Even though we tease you, it's all in good fun, totally. It's fine. It's just the book. The right stuff. Have you seen a book like that, Katsu?
I don't think so, Victor. After all, you can't really find things when the sky's so groovy, like your heart.
Is that what he told
them? Eh?
Oh, is that what he wrote about them in his diary?
Oh, Hitaria, we'll help you find it. After all, we're like the monster under your bed, right? This time we'll do the right thing.
What?
Oh, another one! If only someone like you liked you. You're so lonely you cried yesterday, right? Oh.
My heart breaking.
What do you know?
Felicia was terrified. He knew he wouldn't like this. Slowly, the boy lifted up something in his hand.
It was a book with the flag of Italy at the cover with a small spaghetti sticker at the bottom.
You... I found this in one of your classroom lockers.
Dang it, I'll lock those things.
Give it back. Oops, not so fast. Give it back, please.
Why should I? You never write anything good. You must rewrite how sad you are. Maybe if you just man up, I'll probably give this back to you. Maybe if you stop being a bitch, maybe he wouldn't have to write all that sad stuff. Just saying.
But what are the chances? Come on, hit me with your best shot.
Poor little lonely Hitaria. This diary is awful anyway.
Let's just...
No! Damn. Now nobody will know your secrets and feelings. Isn't this what you want? Well, it's getting late. Let's go home, Victor.
Yeah. Hey, Delia, you should write your feelings right now. Like the sissy you are.
At least nothing worse happened, am I right?
That's sad.
I ruined my dream journal!
I did not!
I'm sorry. I had to say that reference.
Maybe I can save it. But they're right. We never write happy things.
Don't worry, it's not your fault, Felie. It's those bitches' fault. I'm sorry, I don't care that I'm in school anymore. I say what I want.
Time to leave school then.
Music is so sad.
I'm home.
Feliciano?
It's his grandpa!
Ciao, grandpa.
Is there something wrong?
Hey, is that female Sweden on the bottom left corner? That's cool.
Nothing. It's nothing, grandpa. I'm just tired, I guess.
Do you want to take a nap for a while?
Maybe.
Alright. You go upstairs. I'll wake you up for dinner.
Thanks, Grandpa.
Dinner will be ready soon. Be patient, okay?
At least I have a nice, loving grandpa.
He's so good.
He's so good. It makes my heart melt.
So many books I haven't read. Just a closet filled with clothes. Just where I keep my toys, but I don't often play them. Is it bedtime?
I guess it's time to wait. Let me check the other stuff first.
Lovey! This is Lovey's room. He doesn't like it if I come in without permission. This is baby Jojo's room. He's probably sleeping right now.
Aww.
You should be good back then.
This is Grandpa's room. I shouldn't go in without permission.
Wait, I never saw Rome in the flash forward. What happened? Oh, okay. So I guess I'll go to sleep then. Oh, gotta go to sleep. Gotta go to sleep. Yeah, it's bedtime.
I'm so tired. I just want to sleep. Nobody will hurt me while I'm asleep, right?
No, you're safe.
Every day, it was always like this. And every day, the young boy would get more tired. Days, months, even years passed. People around him always wondered, when did the boy smile? For the boy never found joy in his life. For his eyes never shined like the children around him. He never even celebrated his 17th birthday. His last sleep. Those who were close to him kept asking, what would happen if he found a friend? A friend who can give that warm light for the boy.
Oh, Vino. Dude.
This can't be the ending, right?
Yeah, this ending sucks, to be honest. I'm sorry, but...
I wish it's not.
Aww. But... why did you write this? No offense, but I don't really like it.
Because...
it's about his brother, isn't it? Like, the true story of what happened?
Oh, Vino. Why are you crying?
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, but...
Those dull eyes will always haunt them. For every day, they will weep for the boy who never found joy in his life. Wondering what would happen if he found someone who could reach out for his hand in need.
Brother Sister Productions present! Are you kidding me? This is it?
Wait, what?
Aw, that's all?
Well, actually, I did see, like, previews for more stuff, so... Maybe if I went back to... I don't know.
I'm not accepting this ending. I am gonna go and find a better ending. I'm gonna not...
I don't know what I could do.
But I'm gonna find a better ending! Somehow! I don't know how!
Okay, maybe what I did wrong was that I went to sleep before I was supposed to? I don't know. Like, Esfeli, I went to sleep before I was supposed to sleep. Hey, I'm back. Hey, what's up? What I did earlier was Oh. I'm lost now. Was that, you know, I didn't check the diary to see if it was that it was missing. So I could go home. I could just go straight home right now. But I'm gonna check around this town, you know, see what this town beheld and all that stuff. Hey, watch out! And also, I didn't follow the path to home. Hey, are you okay? Like, even though the face has grown up, I think they're supposed to be kids, so I'll just do it.
Eh? Who is this kid? What happened to you? You look like you were beaten by some orcs. Huh? Orcs? Were you hunting for them? Or you got ambushed? They were... not orcs? Not orcs. Then ogres. Ogres? Or even worse, swamp ogres? At the swamp? Oh no! No, not orcs or ogres. Just... it's not a big problem. You don't have to worry. Meh. Oh, I know how to cheer you up.
Meh? What?
Let's go on an adventure.
Meh? Adventure?
Yeah. It always cheers me up when I'm sad. Here.
Hey, don't cover my eyes.
You have to close your eyes first, or else we can't go through the gateway.
What gateway?
Here we go.
Wait a minute.
Reality be rent. Snaps break. Banishment. This. World.
Yay! I knew I should have gone home today. And gotten that bad ending.
You can open your eyes now.
Huh? But...
wait, what the heck? The MFDs... the face is different now. Okay, so, I guess what I was supposed to do was not go back home.